In the food chain, plants are termed producers, as they convert energy from the sun into food. Food for the primary consumers, the herbivores, that only feed on plants as their source of energy. And then, on the top of the food chain, there are the carnivores, the secondary consumers, that eat other animals to obtain their energy. This feeding relationship seems to be the basic principle of life on Earth. The more surprising is it that one group of plants managed to evolve tools that allowed them to break away from the bottom of the food chain and become carnivores themselves. They are no longer the food of animals, instead animals became their food. The most iconic of these carnivorous plants is probably the Venus flytrap. But why did they evolve like this, and how exactly does its unique mechanism of catching prey work? That's what we are going to find out in this episode of Facts in Motion. The inner workings of the Venus flytrap. Hope you enjoy. Most carnivorous plants live in swamps and marshes, with soils so waterlogged they are very poor in essential nutrients like nitrogen and phosphorus. So in order to survive in these harsh environments, they evolved mechanisms that allow them to trap and digest insects and other small animals that then provide these plants with the nutrients they can't find in the ground. There are many different kinds of carnivorous plants, each with its own method of killing. Pitfall traps use the simplest method, a vertical tube that fills with water and drowns anything that falls into it, which are sometimes even relatively large animals, like rats and frogs. Flypaper traps utilize sticky mucilage to catch insects that come into contact with it. And then there are the snap traps, the most advanced of all carnivorous plants. Today, there are only two species of snap traps, the Venus flytrap and the waterwheel plant, basically a Venus flytrap that grows underwater, where it captures small aquatic invertebrates and tiny fish. In the wild, the Venus flytrap only lives in a few small patches of wet pine forest in North and South Carolina, in the United States. The plant itself is relatively small, with only 4 to 7 leaves growing outwards from a single point on its underground stem. Each leaf blade consists of two regions, a flat, heart-shaped, photosynthesis-capable petiole, and the leaf, which is shaped into a pair of lobes that form the trap, each with a set of spines along its brim. Within the trap, 6 fine hairs, 3 on each side, that act as triggers. A closer study of these plants showed that they evolved from an ancestral lineage that utilized flypaper traps. The evolution of a mechanism that can completely lock in the prey had 3 important benefits. It allows the plant to catch much bigger animals that provide greater nutritional value. It prevents theft of the prey by other animals, like frogs, and it allows for more complete digestion. This mechanism alone would already be an amazing feat of evolutionary engineering, but there's more. On top of that, a series of adaptations help the Venus flytrap make this process as energy efficient as possible, and even distinguish between living prey and other stimuli. The first adaptation is that the trap will only then snap together when 2 of the hairs are triggered within about 30 seconds of each other. This keeps the plant from reacting to false alarms, like raindrops, while still catching most of the animals, which are likely to brush more than one hair. Another adaptation are the interlocking spines along the margin of the leaf. Although they look like prison bars that are supposed to lock the prey in, they are actually there to allow animals to escape. While the trap shuts so fast it leaves most animals no chance to react, it doesn't close all the way at first. Instead, it gives undersized insects a way to escape by slipping through the spines, saving the plant the expense of digesting an insufficient meal. Only if the prey keeps moving around inside the trap, triggering the hairs at least 5 more times, the trap will close completely and begin digestion. Another safeguard against wasting energy that allows the Venus flytrap to reset in case the prey escaped or something else triggered the trap, like a fallen leaf, for example. But with no muscles or nerves, how can they react like animals? Although the exact science behind it is still not fully understood, in recent years some progress could be made in solving this mystery. Researchers found that when the trap is in its open state, the cells on the inside of each lobe are blown up with water, while the cells on the outside have only little amounts of water in them. This creates a pressure imbalance that forces the lobes in a convex shape. Now, when an insect brushes against one of the sensitive hairs, the bending triggers a tiny electric charge. A charge that builds up inside the cells of the leaf, but that is not enough to stimulate the snap just yet. This electric charge will gradually decay over the next half a minute. So for the electrical signal to exceed the threshold value and close the trap, another trigger must occur within that time frame. If that happens, pores in the cell membranes will open up and water will surge from the cells on the inside of the leaf to those on the outside, till balance is reached. This happens so fast that it causes the leaf to rapidly flip in shape from convex to concave, which closes the trap. Which is interesting because it makes the whole mechanism less like opening and closing your hand and more like cocking a catapult. A process that takes the plant a lot of time and energy, which also explains why the traps need such a long time to reopen. But once the mechanism is set up, all it takes is someone cutting the rope.